It's day one of Daisy. And I'm nervous. It's a cat's butt. Really? Ugh. This is why I'm getting a service dog and not a service cat. I've spoken in front of thousands and thousands and thousands of people, big crowds, and I've never been as nervous.
Turn left onto Hartley Road.
As I am right now. Here we go.
Welcome to your first day of handler training.
Are all my... Hi, Daisy.
You don't even know.
Shh, wait, she's super calm.
I know, it's because she's been at boot camp in my house.
That's awesome.
I know, she's reformed. Daisy said, that's a good girl.
You did.
Maybe she caught me because I'm having some sort of anxiety attack.
She's doing it because you're doing this.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is that
which
a thing?
Is the alert.
Oh, see, she's smarter than I am. Okay. Easy touch. Easy touch. Easy touch.
Perfect.
Easy touch.
She coaxing.
Easy touch. Easy touch. Good girl.
Nice.
Good girl.
A
plus. So I just got
back
on my first day. And it ended 2 hours ago, but I drove around for a long time. I was just like, it sounds really dumb, but I had just like a flood of emotions. Like, it's the first time, and it went really well. Katie is very patient, and Daisy apparently likes me a lot. She really likes me. Daisy, watch me. Good girl. There's a part of me that thought for a minute, hey, this isn't just a cool dog, this is a dog that's helping me with my PTSD. And that's what made me sad, just to think that I need a dog. I don't need a dog. I could certainly live my life without a dog, but it's gonna help. I think it's good that I'm fighting for myself to get help, even if the help is in a form of Daisy. I feel like a dork because it's a dog, but it's a dog that's gonna change my life. That's a good sound quote.